Hello, good afternoon, Aishwarya.
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah, good afternoon, Ms. Aishwarya. I'm the placement officer.
This is Chandrakala, ma'am, placement officer. This is Deepa, ma'am.
Hi, good afternoon, Aishwarya.
Hi, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, Aishwarya.
Hello, ma'am, good afternoon.
Yeah, welcome. Welcome to DBJ awareness program.
Yeah.
Deepa ma'am, start pannalama?
Ma'am, another few minutes, ma'am. Let the participants join,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, all.
Good evening, Vidya.
Good evening,
good evening, Vidya.
Good evening, Deepa, ma'am. Good evening, Chandrakala, ma'am. Good evening, Deepa, ma'am. Good evening,
hi,
all.
Vidya. Hi, Vidya.
Hi, ma'am. Hi.
Yeah, happy welcome to the DB Jain College for Career Guidance Program for 12th students, especially. I request Shyam Kumar to deliver the welcome address.
Can I start, ma'am?
Yeah, start.
Okay. So very good evening to all. I'm Shyam Kumar, third year BCom General. I take a privilege to welcome you all for this webinar titled Career Opportunities After 12th in Commerce Stream, conducted by Department of Commerce in association with Department of Training and Placement in Dhanraj Bain Jain College. On behalf of DB Jain student, my sincere thanks to management, our President Sri Dayachand Savanskar sir, our Secretary Administration, Dr. Harish Mehta, sir, Secretary, Academic and Finance, Sri Jashwant Munod, sir, Professor in Charge, Dr. M. Shaktivel Murgan, sir, who has given all the support to conduct the webinar to students during the lockdown period. I heartily welcome to our Commerce Faculties and our Placement Officer. My hearty welcome to our Chief Guest, CA Aishwarya Ramesh, for our online webinar session. And now I request Professor Vijaya Govindarajan, ma'am, to deliver the Chief Guest profile.
Yes. Thank you, Shyam. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great privilege for me to introduce today's resource person, Ms. Aishwarya Ramesh, a practicing chartered accountant and a company secretary. She is going to talk to you all, your young aspirants, about the most common personal question you all have been pondering for a while now. What are the career opportunities after 12th commerce? This is the subject you would be deeply interested because it is by taking the right decision today about your career that you can best ensure a secure future tomorrow. Our speaker, Ms. Aishwarya Ramesh, is the best person to advise you on that. She, after completing her class 12, besides joining BCom, decided to take her CA CPTA exams and enroll for ACS as well. By age of 23, she has completed both Chartered Accountancy and Company Secretary course besides BCom. She is passionate about teaching and guiding the young minds in their career path through our YouTube channel. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcome Ms. Aishwarya Ramesh. Over to you, Ms. Aishwarya.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Can I start now?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. So I want to share my screen, and I think I don't have the access for sharing the screen. The host has to enable me in sharing the screen, ma'am. Will you please help me on that?
Yeah. Shyam, can you please share the screen?
Ma'am, actually, enable. Chandrakala, ma'am, actually change the host, ma'am, because.
Ma'am, Chandrakala, ma'am, can you please?
Yeah, I have disabled, ma'am.
Yeah, it's been disabled now. You can please continue, Aishwarya.
No, I'm not able to share the screen. You will have to give me the access so that I can share the screen and start with the PPTs.
Just a minute, ma'am. I'm sorry for this.
Yeah, no problem.
Ma'am.
Chandrakala, ma'am.
You can make me as a co-host so that I can share the screen.
Yes, you can make it, Shyam. You can disable me and you can make it co-host.
No, ma'am, you have the full option, ma'am, because I changed you as a host. Ma'am, the
Deepa ma'am, can you help in this?
So much. Yes, good evening all of you. I am extremely feeling pleasure to be a part of this webinar this evening to share my knowledge on career opportunities after 12 in commerce. So I just want to begin with telling all the students here a very small story. A man was walking and he saw a big elephant which was tied to a very small rope. And it wasn't even trying to escape from there or move away from that rope. He saw the elephant trainer and he went towards him and asked him, how is this possible? The elephant is not even trying to move away from the releasing from that small rope. Then the trainer replied, when the elephant was so small, I had tied the elephant using this rope, which at that point of time, that is when the elephant was so small, it was enough to hold the elephant with that rope. The elephant was conditioned and it started believing that it cannot move away from releasing this rope in its lifetime. And thereby it is not able to get its freedom, and it always thinks that this rope cannot be released. So students here, please have made you believe that you are only an average student or you cannot do something great and prove yourself to the world. So from now on, I request you all to just forget about all those incapable feelings that you have and move away from that. Now, after your secondary education, you have enough opportunities, I'm going to share it to you. With an open mind, listen to it so that you can pursue any one of it and prove your capabilities to the world. All right? So this is the moral that you'll have to understand from the story of the elephant. Don't be like the elephants which is struck in a single place without understanding its capabilities after it has grown up. All right? So the first course that I want to share it to you is about chartered accountancy. All of you would be aware of this course. So I just tell you what are the routes which can be used to complete this course, as well as the pros and cons of this course. Yes, chartered accountancy, you can pursue this course after you are 12th standard, that is immediately after you are 12th standard, or you can do this after completing your graduation. So when you take up this course after you are 12th standard, you will have three levels here, and as well as you will have articleship to be completed. So immediately after you are 12, you can enroll yourself with ICAI, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and you will have to appear for the foundation exam. So now if you are planning to enroll for CA, you can register yourself with ICAI and your examination will be by the November month of this year, that is 2020 November. So this foundation exam, which is like your entrance exam, will have four papers to be completed. And once you complete this, you will move on to the next level, which is called the level intermediate. Here, you will be having eight papers to be completed. Once you complete this level would be divided into two groups containing four in each of the groups. Once you complete this level or any one of the groups in this level, you will have to start with your articleship training. Articleship is nothing but you will be working under a chartered accountant, a practicing chartered accountant, or also you can take industrial training for 3 years. So this, after your intermediate, you will take up your articleship and this will go for 3 years. So during your last 3 months, 6 months of articleship, you can start preparing for final exam and you can also appear for your final exams. Once you are done with this final exam, which will contain 8 papers, you will become a chartered accountant, right? Apart from these levels, you will have small courses which you will have to enroll with ICAI and do it in between or before appearing for final course and intermediate course. Those are very, very small, maybe a 10-day course or 15-day course, which is a part of the CA curriculum. But the major things are foundation, intermediate and final courses. Apart from this, you will be having the articleship to be completed. So this is one route, foundation course route, we call it. The next route is direct entry route. So you don't want to take up a professional course immediately after your 12th standard. You want to complete your BCom or any other graduation. You can go for it. You can start doing your graduation. And once you complete your graduation, you can do chartered accountancy course. At that point of time, you are exempted from doing foundation. You need not again appear for foundation as you have already trained and you have educated for 3 years in the graduation course. But for this exemption, you will have to secure at least 55% if you have taken up any commerce graduation or if you have taken any other graduation other than commerce, you require 60% marks in your graduation. If that is there, you will be exempted in the foundation course and you can straight away start with your articleship. Articleship again in this route is for 3 years, but once you complete 9 months of initial period of articleship, you can appear for intermediate level. The same thing for intermediate and final exam, 8-8 papers as we saw in the foundation route. So after completing intermediate, you will do your remaining period of articleship and then with final and you become a chartered accountant. So this is how the examination goes for CA. So the next course I wanted to tell you, I'll be talking about the cost of this course, the duration and other things in a while. Before that, I want to discuss about the course called Company Secretary. See, if you are interested in numbers, accounting and all these things, you can take up CA. But if you're not interested in numbers, but of more theory and more of law, you can take up Company Secretary, which is more or less like CA. The demand for the course, the course curriculum, everything is like CA. But we here in Company Secretary, we talk or we learn more of the corporate laws, the Indian laws, the labor laws and other things. Here again, like Chartered Accountancy, you will have three levels. Foundation, executive and professional. It is same like CA, but here we call it in a different name, foundation, executive and professional. Again, here in Company Secretary, you will have articleship to be completed, but you have a certain level of flexibility here. If you want to start working under a company secretary or take up industrial training immediately after your foundation, that is your entrance exam, then you will have to undergo 3 years. If not that, you can also complete your executive. Like you complete your foundation, then do your executive. After completing executive, you can start with your articleship. There, you will have to do only for 2 years and not 3 years. But if you plan to complete your education, the qualification completely, foundation, executive, and professional, after all completing all the three levels, you can start with your articleship, wherein you will have to do only for 1 year. So depending upon when you choose to do your articleship, the duration of this course will also differ. Maybe it will take 3 to 4 years at maximum. It depends on at what stage you want to take up your articleship. The next course in the list is Cost Management Accountant. As I was discussing CA, CS, this course is also in the same bunch. This also, the curriculum, the course and everything is as same as CA and CS, but here we focus more on cost management. In CA, we focus more on the financial management and other things. Here, the focus is on cost. But the demand for this course in the small and medium-sized organization is slightly less because all these small and medium-sized organizations do not have compulsory cost audits or other things to be managed. But with respect to CA, more it requires, the demand is more even at the level of small and medium organization. But when you look at the large organization, the demand for CA, CS, CMA are all same. Here again in CMA, you will have three levels, foundation, intermediate, and final. Okay. So coming to the cost, duration, and the job opportunities in these three fields. So when you look at the cost for these three fields, the institute cost, that is for registering in the institute, for taking up those small courses which is offered, the compulsory courses which is offered by the institute, the amount to be paid to purchase the books, the examination fee, if we take up all these things together, the cost would go up to 70 to 80,000 or maximum it can go up to 1 lakh, not more than that. But if you want to get yourself trained from an external tutor, like the external individual classes that has been taken by the private institutions, that will cost you separately. I have not included that cost here because that will depend on the institute that you're, the private institute that you're choosing, the place, location and everything. So at institute level, from the institute point of view, the cost would be 70 to 80,000 for all the three courses. Maybe 5,000 or 10,000 plus or minus would be there. The duration of the course, again, it depends on, for CA, CS and CMA, it depends on at which level you take up the articleship. And for CA, it will take 4 to 4.5 years to complete CA. But CS and CMA, you can manage to complete in 3 to 4 years itself. So at an average, all these courses will take, all these three courses will take 3 to 4 years to be completed if you take it up after your 12th. Job opportunities. See, all the three courses will have, will cover the Indian laws, Indian tax laws, corporate laws and other things. So with respect to India, the job opportunities at, for all these three courses are really high. And at this scenario, at this current situation, all the three jobs will give you bright job opportunities. You can, when you take up these three courses, when you complete these three courses, you can either choose to be employed in a company, any top companies, any MNCs, or you can choose to be on your own shoes. You can start practicing with your own company. You can start your own company and practice as a chartered accountant, or you can practice as a company secretary, or you can practice as a cost and management accountant. So when it comes to direct entry route in chartered accountancy, the duration that it takes would be slightly high. I'll tell you, most of the students would be asking me, would be one question would be running in your mind, whether to take up these courses after 12th standard is better, or it is better to take it up after your graduation. You can take it after your 12th standard, or you can also do it after your graduation. It completely depends on how you see these courses. See, some students used to say, like, I want to enjoy my graduation, so I will do that, and after that I'll be enrolling for professional courses. You can, your point of view is, I don't say it is completely right, but that is also fine. You can complete your graduation and do these courses, but if you decide to do so, you will have to take a slightly, maybe 1 or 2 years extra to complete the professional courses. I'll suggest you just one method which has been followed by many currently doing CA students. You can start, you can write, you can enroll yourself in a college immediately after you are 12. Choose the best college for you, which will bring out all the capabilities in you and will guide you in a proper way. Choose a best college for you. Enroll yourself in the college and also start doing your CA courses. You can complete your foundation as well. You can complete your intermediate. But then you will have to face some hectic days wherein you will have to run with the college, with the CA courses, exams and other things. But if you're able to manage, you can do it. So after your intermediate, you cannot start up with your articleship as you are in the as you are already undergoing graduation. You will not be allowed to start with your articleship. you can complete your third, maybe by completing intermediate, you will be mostly in the second level, second year of your college. You can leave, starting with the articleship for one more year, you can wait, complete your third year of college, and after that, you can start your articleship and then give your final. This is one method which is being followed by many students, but then as you're doing graduation as well as CA, you will have to face some hectic days. You will have to run behind all the classes and other things. But then if you want to have college as well as your professional courses, you can try this. Or otherwise, the foundation route would be like the better choice for you. All right, I just want to share this. Yes. So after these professional courses, you have many other courses, and some of it would be to pursue law. Either you can pursue BA, LLB in a college which is offering law courses, or you can do a normal graduation, a BCom graduation or any other thing, and choose to do some certificate courses. Like, there are a lot of certified courses that is available in many colleges as well as many institutions, like any certificate courses in corporate laws, certificate courses in intellectual property laws. You can also choose to do that, because now the demand for corporate law certified courses, the demand for intellectual property professionals are becoming huge in our country. Apart from this, I would also like to mention about a career opportunity, which is about an actuarial course. Actuarial course is all about the assessment of the risk in an insurance company, or assessment of the risk in the mines and other things. Basically, it deals with the assessment of risk. If you are a person who is most interested in numbers, math, statistics, and other things, this course will definitely meet your passion towards numbers. But this course is considered to be slightly higher in difficult level as compared to the other professional courses. But the demand for actuarial profession is huge in India. And the competition is also very less, which if you want to use this course, you can use and get succeed in your career. The next thing that I want to suggest you is, if you're a person who is thinking like, I don't want to get into all these professional courses, which is going to give me a lot of difficult times, which I have to put in a lot of hard efforts and other things, you can very well start with your BCom or BBA and choose to do your MBA in a top college after your BCom or MBA, any graduation. All right. So apart from all these things, see, I am discussing about all the professional courses, all the commerce related courses and other things. But apart from this, especially during this lockdown, I realized the importance of other courses also, especially a course on digital marketing. See, I myself is a person who learned digital marketing maybe a few months back. And during this lockdown, I realized the importance, I realized the demand for a digital marketer. And with that, my knowledge on the previous learning of the digital marketing, which helped me in starting a YouTube channel, and it is going well with few subscribers increasing day by day. So you can also, I don't suggest to take up this course as a full-time, the digital marketing part. You can also pursue this course, the digital marketing one, or a course on photography and all these things, which will also fill up your craving towards passion. And also, it will give you some job opportunities in future. Maybe in part-time, you can also pursue this. And visual communication, definitely day by day, the demand for all these things are increasing. So these are the list of courses which I want to tell you if that is available in India. Apart from this, we have National Accountancy Organization. This course is offered by the UK Association. So here you'll be reading about more law related to UK, the UK GAP, IFRS, and UK laws. And this course has been recognized in more than 170. By more than 170 countries, and again this course has three levels, wherein if you want to do this course ACCA after your 12th standard, you will have to appear for 13 papers and clear these 13 papers. But if you want to do this course after your graduation, you have an exemption for 4 papers and you will have to give only 9 papers. But then if you want to have global recognition, if you want to explore job opportunities at global level after completing your CA, you are given a lot of exemption and you will have to write only 4 papers and you can complete this course in just 1 year after completing your CA. So it is advisable to start, if you plan to start a professional course, it is advisable to start with CA after completing CA with just 1 more year of your studies. With ACCA, you can complete that course to gather, to explore some global opportunities. Right, coming to CPA. This is a US-based course, US Certified Public Accounting. This is considered as highest standard of competence in the field of accountancy across the globe. The exam is administered by the American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, AICPA, which is the world's largest accounting body. This AICPA is considered to be the world's largest accounting body, followed by the ICAICA Institute, which is the second largest body in the world, the accounting body in the world. So apart from these two things, there are many other international courses like USCMA and all other courses are there, which will give you a lot of global career options, global job opportunities after completing these courses. And if you ask me like whether to take up an Indian Chartered Accountant or an US-based CPA or ACCA, the suggestion is like, it depends on how you, what job opportunities you expect or what is your mindset. In CA, CS, CMA and all, we will be reading more of Indian laws, more laws related to Indian taxation and other things which will have more focus on Indian things. Of course, we are also going to read some international things there, but then the more focus is going to be on the Indian laws. But when you look at CPA, this is going to be more of US things, US laws, and ACCA is going to be of UK thing. But these two courses have more global recognition than the Indian courses. Of course, the Indian courses are also gaining a lot of recognition, but these are all the courses, these two courses already have huge global recognition. You can choose to do any of the courses with the options that I have given you. But before you choose a course, just eliminate all the preoccupancies with respect to your inabilities or with respect to any thought that you are just an average student or any thought that you are just a below average student. You cannot do all these professional courses. Just move away all these thoughts from your head. Just throw it away and then start analyzing each of these options and decide which one to be taken. And with respect to the cost of these international courses will cost you definitely higher than the Indian course. As I told you, CA, CS, CMA, all these professional courses will cost you maybe maximum 1 lakh with the institute fee. But CPA and ACCA, thank you.
Yeah, thank you. It's a very wonderful session. Very thank you so much. And I request Mr. Shyam Kumar to deliver the vote of thanks.
Very good evening again. On behalf of DBGN College, it was indeed a privilege to have a CA Aishwarya Ramesh, Chartered Accountant, Fractional Company Secretary, Chennai. Her insightful lecture on career opportunities after 12th in Commerce team. Once again, I thank you, ma'am, for having spared your precious time for all of us. I express my profound gratitude to our management, Dr. Shaktivel Murugan Sir, Department of Placement Training and Department of Commerce, for organizing such a thought-provoking session. Thank you all once again for the success of this online webinar session. Thank you, ma'am.